Since the 1990s, India has been a global leader in providing technology services to the rest of the world. But as the second most populous nation on Earth continues to grow, a new generation looks to new frontiers in which to stake its future. India is getting a brand update, setting its sights on high-tech innovation and entrepreneurship. And the southwestern state of Kerala is stepping up to be the home of high-tech in India. Within Kerala, Kochi is the place of the future that is emblematic of this shift, and maybe, one day, a paragon for India itself. I'm Caroline Steer from the Center for the Future of Work, and I'm here in Kochi to explore this shift manifesting in India. We're turning to Kerala to see how everyone should be preparing for a future driven by innovation. There's something about places of the past and future that lie on Western shores. Silicon Valley, Tel Aviv, Kochi. Perhaps it's the historical movement of ships from east to west into port. Kochi was the historical center of the global spice trade. And with it came a mix of people, cultures, and religions from all across the world. The ports here are still part of the well-established transport ecosystem. Policy in Kerala has broken free from the rest of India's, contesting the idea that GDP is the single most important measure of growth. Instead, Kerala focuses on social infrastructure growth, with policy targeting things like education, healthcare, and life expectancy. This prioritization has led to impressive outcomes, resulting in academics and economists coining the term the Kerala model. People from Kerala, Malayalis, enjoy a quality of life akin to many leading developed countries. The average life expectancy was measured at 75 years, compared to 64 across the rest of India. In education, Kerala has a 94% literacy rate compared to the national average of 74. Kerala has been catching up fast to the developed world since independence in 1947. I spoke with the leaders of Kochi's biannual arts festival, the only Biennale in India, about the Kochi lifestyle and how to equip people with the skills of the future.
Why don't you start by telling me what the Biennale is and why it's here in Kochi?
So the term Biennale means once in 2 years, basically. And the whole idea of the Kochi Biennale was to build an amazing exhibition for visual arts where people can really celebrate the visual arts, not be stuck by barriers of two-dimensionality, medium, the pressures of a market, of what would, you know, appeal to a few and not to a few. So the whole idea was built across, you know, what a Biennale can bring to a city and impact.
The talent here in Kochi will be kind of have the cutting edge because it's grown up in a place that really puts cultural education, the creative education at the center, whilst also being a technology hub. Do you think that makes people here quite unique?
Absolutely. I think that becomes a very important thing that you take back. You look at the IT boom in Bangalore, creativity was not very strong. So you have a lot of people outsourcing people from Bangalore when it became the Silicon Valley. Things have moved to Hyderabad. Again, it's the same problem where I see the difference in Kochi here, where people, like, there was the most amazing maker space here. And the maker movement was invented, started off in Bangalore, but actually the innovation hub here has sort of taken on and much faster than it has in Bangalore or anywhere else.
Thanks to the Kerala model, Kochi is a city with an extraordinarily popular way of life. Unlike other Indian cities that are bursting at the seams, Hyderabad, Chennai, and Bangalore, for example, Kochi is definitively more mellow. As Kochi continues to grow towards a place of the future, the city has plans to ensure that this special Kochi vibe doesn't fade away. One of the biggest lessons learned from larger Indian cities is the need to retain green space across the city, even in the tech hubs. Whilst a blade of grass is hard to come by in other Indian tech metropolises, Kerala is lusciously green. Sustainability is a huge focus for Kochi. It's home to the only airport powered on solar energy. Because of this impressive achievement, Kochi Airport won the United Nations' highest environmental honor in 2018, the prestigious Champions of the Earth Award. other cities should pay close attention. We talked to the director of Kochi's solar-powered international airport about how it's helping Kochi do business and about Kerala's green future.
2015, we became the first airport in the world completely powered by solar energy. We produced almost 146,000 units of power every day, and we consume about 120,000 units per day. So we have a surplus. We produce about 40 megawatts of power. And as the requirement goes, we are buying land elsewhere and producing solar power. So we will remain as a 100% solar airport for the years to come also.
It might be easy to get into Kochi through the impressive airport, but it's also easy to get out. One crucial and persistent challenge for continued growth in Kochi is brain drain.
Currently, there aren't enough job opportunities for the number of highly skilled knowledge workers that Kerala itself creates. In reality, the state runs on remittances. How will Kochi address this brain drain? Or is there a positive side to the global movement of Malayalis that cannot be overlooked?
Obviously, because I think once major companies come here, you will not see this brain drain happening. They all come back. So they will come back with a better knowledge also. Mm-hmm. But we anticipate that major companies will set up shop here.
The future of work hinges on a powerful network effect that drives clusters of talent all around the world. Top-down hierarchies are a thing of the past. Kochi's budding technology ecosystem is ready to take full advantage of this shift from hierarchy to wirearchy. There's an impressive network of spaces in the growing tech hubs of the city, and we're going to explore a few of them. First up, the growing startup and incubation space at Kerala Startup Mission, which after the completion of three more projects will be the largest in the world.
Why don't we start by just explaining what Kerala Startup Mission is and why it's based here in Kochi?
Kerala Startup Mission is primarily to develop a tech ecosystem in the state of Kerala. So you are looking at developing hardware companies, software companies who work in multiple domains. We have presence across Kerala, but our largest facility is in Kochi. And Startup Mission works at multiple levels, right from school level onwards, because the spirit of innovation is basically what is going to drive the next stage of the future. And so we work with schools where we put them with students with interesting problems. And when we come to the colleges, we set up small innovation entrepreneurship development cells, where people can actually try out those innovative ideas into an entrepreneurial framework. And for that, we provide the infrastructure support and things like that. And we have set up a set of infrastructure facilities. For example, the largest fab lab, super fab lab outside MIT, set up by MIT is in Kochi. And this actually help companies who are getting into high-end hardware manufacturing, companies who are getting into embedded systems and things like that.
So you see the investment in companies in Kochi and Kerala more generally rising very much over the next 5 to 10 years.
Yeah, absolutely. Because we build this startup ecosystem more by brick by brick, like right from lower level we build it. And the ecosystem has actually reached a level of maturity now, and now it's in the stages of taking off.
I met with some of Kochi's leading investors and entrepreneurs in another area, the Info Park, to understand why money is pouring into the tech ecosystem here and what the impact of further infrastructure development will be on the future of Kochi.
And so the government said, you know, whatever you want, however you want to do it, you know, we'll help you. So that flexibility helped. We were setting up a small 50-member team. It's not going to be that hard to find people. So we have grown, you know, we're about 250, 300 people and mostly locally sourced.
Kochi is a very cosmopolitan place. So you have got people from all sort of culture. If you look at the religion here, it is Hindus, Muslims, Christians, all of the things are balanced here. And the people are very friendly in that sense. You have all sort of people from all different parts of India also coexisting here for centuries. So, and also, its connectivity is really good.
Kochi has been a great choice for us so far.
So let's zoom out to Kochi more widely. What do you think the future has in store for Kochi as a city?
We are very well connected. We are connected with Malaysia 4 times a day, Singapore 2 times a day, Dubai, it's about 14 flights a day. Hopefully in the next 2 to 3 years time, you will have this Air Kerala starting with the seaplane operations. The whole of Kerala, you have backwaters, rivers. We have 41 rivers flowing into the Arabian Sea. So those rivers and the canals could be utilized for the landing of the seaplane.
It's no wonder that Kochi is a must-visit tourist destination. The green space, the chilled out vibe, the Biennale. But what makes this place unique, the unparalleled focus on social infrastructure, is transforming the city into a hub of technology and innovation. Kochi offers an alternative model for India, one that can accelerate it into a new, more sustainable future of work. Kochi, the place of the future, challenging the status quo that might just come out winning.
The work ahead starts today in these places of the future. Cognizant is already helping customers make their businesses, operations, and work fit for the future in the fourth industrial revolution. To learn more, please visit cognizant.com.